Welcome back to my podcast. This is the How to KDJ podcast for those of you who are new, because there are always new people every day. Okay, so besides the awkwardness of that whole intro, I don't know, I was thinking of saying something, then I was like, should I say it? But then I just kind of gave up halfway. Anyway, this is episode 12, I think, if I haven't rearranged things, but this should be episode 12, so, you know, we're going strong. We're going great, and everything's going well. So, I was going to continue last episode's topic, which was about sexiness, you know, sexy guys and stuff like that. In case you haven't seen it, you should probably click it first. I'm probably going to put a pop-up right here. I'm not sure if I'm going to do it. I'm probably going to be too lazy to do that, but, you know, just, I don't know, try, please. Please, David, try. So, sexiness, right? Getting kind of tired of saying that. I don't know if you can tell, but I'm just kind of tired today, but not really like heavily tired, but I'm not feeling too strong at this today. I don't know what I'm saying. Let's dive into the topic. Today is going to be about women, because I talked about guys extensively last time and it was pretty fun. It was pretty straightforward. But the thing is that that's not all we have. We have other things. We have other genders. So let's go for women. Again, I did a little bit of Googling because I didn't want to have to make this list myself. So I found this website. It's called Best Life Online. No idea who makes this or if this is legitimate in any way. And I'm already seeing some things on this list that don't vibe with me that well. But you know what? We'll talk about each one of them and let's see how far we can go. There's 30 things on this list. 30. Good God. Some people have time on their hands. But, like, there's 30 things on this list, and we're going to be talking about at least a couple of them. Yeah? First things first on this list is wearing a man's dress shirt. Like, what? First of all, like, aside the fact that not every guy has a job where he wears a dress shirt, so, like, that's not even a thing. But second of all, Why is that sexy to people? This is another thing. I'm imposing a lot of my personality in this, which is kind of the point. It's my podcast. But, like, the thing is, I know for the general consensus of people, like, that's a thing that people like, you know? I guess because I see it a lot in movies where they're so close together, then there's always, like, this next shot of them where the lady usually wears his dress shirt and then, like, they're, like, together and all snuggly and all that garbage. But, like, you know, that's a thing, I guess. That's usually a thing. So, you know, I guess that makes sense. On this list it says, especially when it's worn the way men should never wear it. Oversized, hovering over bare legs with three buttons unbuttoned. Yep, that's one thing men find attractive. Okay, moving on. Number two is goofing off every now and then. Okay, so this is, first of all, this is subjective, because a lot of guys, trust me, do not like when women goof off. It kind of just looks cringy to them. They find it cute, but it looks cringy. And I'm not one of those people. Like, this is not even me imposing, because I think I like that. Like, personally, I like it. I said this in the last episode. I like this specific thing in relationships where the two people, the, you know, both partners, are close enough to genuinely, like, laugh together, you know, to feel happy together and to feel good together in general. I feel like that's a thing that it's necessary in every single relationship for it to go well, is that they should, like, have this kind of, like, banter, this funny banter together. And it's not always, like, every banter together doesn't always have to be, like, something serious. It doesn't always have to be a girl who's deep, who understands stuff. And don't take what I said the wrong way. I said girls who's deep, and anyway, whatever. That has a little bit of extra connotations in it, but whatever. The thing is, it is not always like she has to be so profound and stuff. She can just be loose and funny and goofy, and that's nice. You know, it's pretty cool. And at the same time, there's a balance there, right? There's a balance, because I don't personally, because I'm going to impose throughout. This is my podcast. So, like, I have to say what's on my mind, and I will say it has to be understandably goofy, right? I don't want a girl who's just goofy because she's dumb. I don't know how to put this in a nice way, so I'm just going to use that word, the D word in my opinion. Like, I don't like when people are funny because they don't know anything. You know, when they're just like, oh god, I don't know anything. Oh, is this a spoon? What does this spoon have? Why does this spoon have slots in it? Like, why is this spoon so broken down? Like, I don't know. Why am I using a spoon? Good god, I'm really tired today for some reason. I'm really tired today. But like, personally, I don't know. I just don't see that as goofy and funny. I see that more of kind of what's this word? There's like a word like where it's like it's kind of scary. It's kind of weird, but no weird in the, you know, in the insultive sense. But weird like that's strange. Basically, like it's pretty strange when a girl just doesn't know enough and she's kind of trying to cope by laughing, pretty much. Like, you try to laugh and just joke it off, but sometimes it's pretty clear you don't know what you're saying, so you're just trying to hope people find you funny. And sometimes that's good. It's kind of one of the reasons a lot of women find virgins funny, because they find them virgins funny because they're like, oh, this guy really doesn't know enough, he doesn't understand how it works. And like some dudes who don't understand how like women's stuff work, you know, like the cycle, the period, the cramps, all this stuff, they don't really understand any of these things. So a lot of women find that, you know, a little bit cute. So I don't know, so some people see that as a cool thing, but I don't know, I just personally have never found that to be in any way good looking. But besides that, this is a decent one in my opinion. It's just, you know, it has to be a certain way. So you can't just be goofing off every now and then, like, because you're stupid. You should be goofing off because you know enough to know what's the right thing, and you're smart enough to understand that saying it the wrong way or doing it the wrong way is funny. You know, it doesn't have to be broken down like that, but I'm just explaining it in my own words, because that's how I see things. Next thing is laughing when a guy isn't funny. Now, this is a complete deal breaker for me, because I feel like that's borderline dishonesty, right? Because you're another little pet peeve I have about myself is I have this weird thing that I started doing recently where I say right every time I say something. And I'm sure a lot of people who've been watching this podcast, a lot of people, quote unquote, I barely have any views, like a lot of people who are watching this probably like have noticed that I say right anytime I say something. Like, I say right because it's like you're trying to justify what you said by instinctively, you know, forcefully justifying it. You're not waiting for the person to say yes, that's right or that's wrong. You're like, right, right, it's good, right? Yeah, right. No, that's it's not always right. So you have to wait for the other people to respond. You have to know whether it's right or not, whatever. Let's move by the side. So the laughing when guy isn't funny thing is to me a little bit dishonest, because it's like you're practically lying to him. You're telling the person he isn't funny. No, you're telling the person he's funny when he isn't funny. And sometimes people could get hurt from that, because they'll feel like, okay, so what I said wasn't really that funny, and you still gave me, you know, still gave me applause for it, and that kind of, I don't know, a lot of people might feel a little bit hurt from that, and I don't know, it depends on the guy you're dating, of course, because some dudes just want to be, like, justify that they were funny even though they weren't. Some people look for that validation because they just need that to cope, and I know a lot of people like that, so that's a thing, you know, some people just need that. But in my opinion, I would rather you just not laugh if I'm not funny, you know, or you just say I don't get it, you know, because that makes more sense. And then when you don't get it and the person explains it to you, you should know how to play it off that you're trying to understand what they're saying, instead of like, I don't get it, that's stupid, you know, because there are a lot of girls like that. So yeah. I don't know, this is personal experience mixed with a bunch of personal stuff. This is just how I think. Yeah. Next thing is being sweet to a random toddler you see in a... What? No. No. Just no. No. It's not yours. This is the genuine thing. I'm sure a lot of people agree with me on this. Don't like touch other people's toddlers or like be sweet towards other people's belongings, pretty much. Like, don't do that. I don't know why this is a thing, because I know this is a thing. A lot of women genuinely think that makes them look cute and like also sort of what's this word? The word for a woman, for womanly. Oh god, there's a word for this. Like motherly. I don't know. There's a thing. Like, a lot of women feel like that makes them look kind of more like a woman, like a. God, there's no better way to put it than that. But like, that's the thing. I don't like that because it's, you're, in my opinion, you're imposing on someone, you're imposing someone else's thing, you know? It's not yours. So I don't feel like you should be touching or like be playing around with like a toddler or like a dog, for example. A dog is more fine to me, but a toddler just feels like, look, it's your child. You brought that creature up. You're the one creating that creature. You're grooming that creature. Fine. That's none of my business. That's how I see it. And the problem is when you're like in a relationship and both of you are going out together and she does it, it kind of looks weird if you as a guy don't react like she reacts, you know? And that causes issues. My whole thing in relationships is always, if what you're doing in any way makes you, your spouse, or any bystander out there uncomfortable, then something is wrong with it. That's the thing. Then there's a problem there. That's how I've always thought about this, because it's like, if someone genuinely feels bad or someone genuinely feels a certain way in that relationship, then you're doing something wrong. Like, you're just clearly doing something wrong. So I don't know, that's just part of my whole thing. Don't do things that make people feel uncomfortable. Don't do that. And I was going to talk about this in another episode, but I want to bring it up now because I've seen like a lot of accounts, like on YouTube. This is a big side tangent. On YouTube, where like it's pretty much, you know, fitness channels, right? Fitness channels, quote unquote, because I'm going to talk about why I'm putting this in quotes, because a lot of people make channels where, this is a thing, right? Genetically, some women are just more endowed. They just have properties, features that guys find attractive, that a lot of people find attractive, you know, like big breasts or big ass or big thighs and stuff. And thighs, fine. Thighs aren't even really, I think thighs are a hit or miss. A lot of guys like leaner thighs, a lot of guys like fleshy thighs, a lot of guys like muscular thighs, but like, that's, you know, that depends. But ass, specifically butt cheeks and breasts, I feel like those are two things you can't really put that into a category or category of fitness. Why? Because some women just have that and some women don't. And my problem is when a woman is trying to make it look like it's something you can just learn. Like, I don't know if there are any women out there who understand what I'm saying. Like, I don't know if there are any women who even watch what I post or watch my podcast. But like, this thing, there's like a big barrier there that it's very annoying when you're practically lying to other women. You're lying to people that this is something you can just do, when it clearly isn't. Like, it's not a thing you can do, okay? Because it's not, for people who don't understand, especially, like, there's this channel I just popped up on my YouTube store shorts page, because I always scroll around on YouTube shorts. I'm like, that's like my thing for some reason. I don't know, like, just how some people have Instagram and they scroll around on Instagram or Snapchat. I do that same thing for YouTube shorts. I watch a lot of YouTube shorts, dude. Like, it's an unhealthy amount. I'm trying to tone it down nowadays, and I think I'm doing pretty good. But I saw this lady like last night where her whole channel, she has like 15,000 subscribers and a couple of videos. Her whole channel is literally just about the fact that she has a really big ass, like a really big one. Like, I'm not saying this in any form of crude manner. Like, the property of her gluteus maximus is voluptuous. Like, that's the freaking dumbest thing I've ever said. But like, she has a wide, big, thick ass. And the thing with me is, that's fine and all. But when, in what manner? Because this is the thing about fitness. Fitness generally always has this thing where it's supposed to tend towards what could help you in some certain cases in your life. You know, because that's kind of part of the main reason a lot of people go for fitness, because it's like a thing. You know, you want to look good, so you dress up to look good. You make your abs strong so that you can have good core, and these are all things that could affect you when you're moving around, when you're doing stuff, or if you imagine human beings back in time when we're like, you know, foraging and stuff. Like, you can imagine how human beings were, so you'd be like, okay, cool, so this will definitely help you in that scenario. Even if a lot of us in our modern lives now do not need any of these things, but this is just a thing that we've always had, and it's a thing that we've always just, you know, that's always nice to have, like good core, good biceps so you can lift things, a good back, like for good back muscles, also for lifting and also for a lot of different things, and then good legs, you know, thighs, calves and everything. But a good ass, think about it. When would you ever need to have a good, strong, thick butt cheek? Like, or butt cheeks. When would you ever need that? Like, it's one of those things that it's 100% aesthetic. 100%. You can have the flattest, the thickest, it doesn't matter. But you know what's kind of weird? It's not just 100% aesthetic. It's one of those features in the body where the bigger it is, the more inconvenient it actually is. Or is that not a thing for a lot of guys? I know a lot of guys would just like immediately shout around and be like, "Nah, I like a girl with a big ass." Do you really know what it feels like to shop for a woman who has a big ass? Have you really thought about it? Because you can't buy regular clothes if you haven't really realized that. Women with like that much thickness, you can't buy regular clothes. You can dress up normally. You can't sit in regular places. You can't just go to a restaurant and like find a tiny chair or like a bar stool and sit there. It always looks uncomfortable. You can't wear regular clothes because the clothes they can't just be straight gowns, you know? Because the ass will like pull everything slides. Like, if you understand what I'm saying, for those of you who understand this, who probably have girlfriends or know girls who have this property, like, that's a thing. So like, that whole thing just feels excessively insufferable to me. Like, don't mind me using fancy words. Like, I don't know, this is the way I talk, but like, that doesn't feel like a nice thing to me. It doesn't feel like a benefit, you know, to have a big behind. Like, how, that doesn't feel like a benefit to me, because it just makes your life uncomfortable. Think about it. So it's always weird to me that, yes, I understand that there is also the fact that a lot of guys get appealed by seeing a big, thick ass, and a lot of women, because, you know, that's part of our biology, it's part of our genetics. We just have to look appealing to the other gender or to other people just so that we can keep reproducing, because that's kind of the whole point of humanity. I talked about this last time. But like, for women, they like when other people like them, not just guys, women as well. Like, they like when other people see them as good looking, you know, by social standards. So that's cool, that's nice. But when you're deliberately posting stuff like this and guys are reacting the way you'd imagine they would react, which is horny, like, that's the thing. Why do people now go ahead and scream at that and like post like so many? I saw so many comments on that channel and I was like, wait, everyone's just talking about how they keep objectifying her. You've made yourself an object. That's the thing. Your whole account, your whole social media personality is based on the fact that you have a thick ass. That's it. Just nothing else. Oh my god, I mistakenly swiped my camera by accident. Sorry about that. Sorry, I looked crooked for a second. But like, okay, back to what I was saying. You just made an entire social media account just to glamorize how good you look or how good your ass looks. Cool. Because there's nothing else. She doesn't have like an extremely fit, like, anything else. Like, she's a black woman, first of all, so she, like, most likely, clearly, to some people, she's a black woman, so she, like, most black women usually have this toned physique, like, just naturally, because it's just part of how our biology is. So, like, she has that fit physique, like, regular, you know, she has decent shoulders and stuff. Cool. She looks nice, but her entire channel isn't focused on that. It's focused on her ass. God, you should see the clothes she wears. Like, you should see that. And this is one of those things where I'm always like 50-50 hanging on an edge about this whole thing when it comes to dressing etiquette in a gym. This is another huge side tangent. But look, you, like, trust me, you do not need the most flexible, stretchiest, most form-fitting clothes in the gym to work out better. You don't need that. And a lot of women would also say, okay, yeah, but I kind of want to be able to see what I'm doing. I want to be able to see if what I'm doing is working. Yeah, but you're inconveniencing people. You can just expect someone to close their eyes. And the problem is, if women were willing to accept that guys can just like stare at them if they want, based on how good they look, then it's fine. If women were willing to just accept it and just be like, okay, yeah, I'm dressing up like this because I want to see how it feels. I want to really see how it feels is the wrong way of putting that, but a lot of people say that, another pet peeve. But like, I want to know how this feels. I want to know how this looks to other guys and to other women and stuff. Like, I want to see the reactions and stuff. Cool. Then when every guy looks at you and leers at you because you have that much ass, and it's like it's not even a wedgie at this point. Like, you're wearing form-fitting clothing that leaves absolutely nothing to the imagination. You should see the camel toes on Little Eve. It's like, come on, it's too tight. It's like, the crazy thing is, it's not even tight, it's just form-fitting. That's why I kept saying form-fitting, because it's not uncomfortable, you know, quote-unquote. They want to basically be able to work out like they're naked. That's it. They want to work out like they are literally naked. And like I've said, if that's what you want, and you want people to be able to see how good you look like that, fine. But you should be willing to accept the consequences of basically turning on a bunch of random dudes in a gym. You should be willing to accept that. So, side tangent over. I don't really want to keep talking about that too much, because I've already said a lot, and I might make a whole video about that, because this is a big thing to me. Like, the way people react when guys like react to what they do, which is meant for that, but then they're like, no, I don't want that. But like, they want it, but they don't want it. Come on, just come on. You can't be that two-sided. You can't just do that. Okay, you can't just dress up anyhow you want. And when people react the way they would react to that, you were like, no, I don't like that. Don't, like, please respect my, what do you want them to respect? You've made yourself an object. You've done that. You've literally made yourself an object. And people are like, cool, that's nice. I like the object you've made yourself into. Like, that object looks nice. But then when you talk about it and stuff, when guys look at it and when guys talk to it, like, they're like, oh, oh, if you objectify, what do you want them to say? Okay, on the videos, you want every single video she's making literally about her ass to be, oh, I like your physique. Really? Oh, you're working so hard, girl. Keep good at it. That's not a thing. That's people hiding what they should be saying. And in my opinion, that's more false. You're basically trying to make sure guys are not saying the full thing that's on their mind. And that's just wrong. That's just straight up wrong. You shouldn't do that. You shouldn't make guys feel that way. So anyway, I don't know. This is just, I don't know. It's just a thing I've always seen. Also on this list, for some random reason, number 5 is kettlebell swings. What the hell? What? Kettlebell swings. It says there are key aspects of kettlebell swings: the intensity, the power of movement, the whole body extending, exuding strength from every tendon. That puts the move a cut above everything else. As far as sex appeal is concerned, it's to men what a guy. What? 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 How many guys look at girls doing kettlebell swings and think, wow, that's making me horny? What? Just what? I don't even see. I have nothing else to say about that. Just what? Okay. Moving on, please, like, swiftly. Number 6 is giving credit when it's due. That's always great. Like, that's fine, you know? When a person says something, like, let me break this down. Pretty much what this is saying, based on my understanding, is like, when you clearly didn't do something yourself and you weren't like the originator of something, you should be able to give credit that, okay, this person did this, or this person was the idea behind this. And like, it's always nice, because like, I think this is just a general thing. This is just part of one-on-one being a human being, or being a good person, is like just being able to understand when to say, I didn't do this on my own. You know, someone else did this first, and I'm pretty much just copying that. Yeah, or being able to give credit that, oh my god, that was so nice what you did. Like, that's the thing. And I don't know if this is even a sexy thing. I think this is just 101 humanity. Anyway, number 7, a tilt and a gaze. So this is another one of those things that I was kind of expecting on this list, because, you know, it's like a list about sexiness, and sexiness is always very subjective. But like, this is more of like a thing you do, like a kind of trait that a lot of women possess, which is like the ability to, it's kind of like these, like a smirk for a guy, or like a scowl. I mean, sometimes a scowl looks good, sometimes it looks like you're scowling. By scowl, I mean like, it's kind of a weird face, sort of like a pissed off face. Like, for those of you not watching that, I just took off my glasses. So like, it's like, it's almost like disgust, but not really much disgust. But there are some guys who can pull it off and make it kind of look good for some reason. I don't know. It's just a thing apparently that a lot of guys have. And yeah, that's a thing that a lot of girls like as well. And for girls, it's a tilt on the gaze where it's like she... It's kind of like a sort of a side eye look. And I don't know, that's one of those little things that just kind of turn guys on for some reason. Because we're absolute robots. So next thing is... It says, Alexa, turn off the volume. What am I reading? Do they say this because they know someone's reading it out and they think I have an Alexa? They think I'm gonna say this and it's gonna affect my Alexa or something. Also, my browser just died for some reason. My browser just froze up. I don't know what the hell is going on. It's not even moving, but it's just frozen. Thank you, browser. I'm not gonna mention what it is for future stuff, for future sake. It says, music. Okay, this is about music. Alexa, turn the volume up. That's just what they titled it because they thought they were clever. Whatever. Well, it's about music. It's pretty much saying sensual, soulful, sultry music. You know, like the ability to like sultry, soft music is apparently a thing. You know, and I get that. You know, tasting music does really help. But that, again, is subjective. I'm telling you, there are people who probably think metal is sexy. Like, some people think metal music is sexy. So, like, you know, it depends on who you are. It depends on what you like. It depends on you. Yeah? Next thing is slow sip. And now, a slow sip, to me, absolutely not. That's completely not a thing to me. I don't know. I feel like that's probably nurtured in a way to me, because it's another thing I don't like. And this is a specific one, because this feels a little... When I say next, I'm going to say it. This sounds racist, but it's not. Hear me out. Just please hear me out first. Hear me out, okay? White women, right? There's this thing that they started. I'm 110% sure they started this. Where they kind of... You know this that look? Well, Burnham has made a video about this already. Like, about white women. It's literally... I think it's probably called White Women. It's a whole song. It's pretty funny. But it's like this thing where they wear, like, long sleeves with, like, thick cloth. And then they're like, they carry the cup of tea and they're sipping it just ever so slowly, like just taking a little bit. Good God, I've never wanted to punch something more than I ever wanted. I don't know. It just really freaking creeps me out. Like, what the hell? Just drink the darn thing. And I'm not even like a fast eater. Like, I'm not one of those people who rushes food or rushes drinks. I do drink pretty fast. I'm not going to lie. Like, not drink, like, alcohol, right? I drink beverages pretty fast, and that's a side thing, and that really does affect me, because that makes me drink. Why am I talking about myself like this? This is, personally, I just don't see why you need to sip, why you have to do that whole thing. And yes, it's probably cozy, it's probably nice, that's probably the reason it feels nice and sultry. It just looks wrong, and the problem is a lot of white women will shove this in your face with all their posts, all their Instagrams, all these things. They make everyone know, yes, this is my life. This is what I like to do. And I like to sip coffee. And that's my entire personality. And sometimes it's not their whole thing, I understand. It's not always good to subjectify what you do because of what they show you. But sometimes, you know, it just pisses me off. But yeah, that thing doesn't, it just stings me wrong, because I've just mentally been trained to find that cringy. So yeah. Be that as it may, it is fine. It's fine if you do that. There's nothing wrong with sipping slowly, and it's always nice to take relaxing sips. A jeer during the middle of a game. Okay, so this is specifically for dudes. Like if you're in the midst of people who like, you know, watching games and stuff, you would like a girl to be as active as you are in the game. And I think that's fine. I think it's always good to, like, in general, even in friendships, it's always good to be able to carry along a general feeling a group of friends have. You know, like, when everyone's feeling cheerful about something, it's always nice to just be able to feel pumped up as well. But yeah, I 100% understand if you don't feel that way. But at the same time, I feel like you should choose the right person as well, because if the girl you're trying to date or something is genuinely just not interested at all, at the very least, in any form of sports you watch, or at least not as much interest as you have, then I feel like that's in a way your fault, because you're trying to make her feel a way she can't feel, you know?
And sometimes it's like, oh, she's perfect in every way, and it's so hard to find a woman this perfect in every way. But that one thing is the issue. Yeah, but that one thing could also make or break your relationship. And that's, you know, that's kind of the sacrifice of life sometimes. Like, it's difficult to find people because there's usually one thing or a couple of things that are just such pet peeves. They're very tiny, minuscule pet peeves, but you don't really want that to be a thing in a relationship that you want to last. Okay, that's my therapy session. Let's go to number 11, which is agreeing to golf dates. I'm not even going to talk about that. That's just pure garbage. I don't know why people play golf. I really don't want to talk about it. Like, that's a freaking waste of land. Whatever. Telling the story behind a first tattoo. Again, subjective. That depends on whether you like or don't like tattoos. I'm fine with it either way, but I've always been one of those types where I'm like, if you don't need it, you shouldn't make something permanent on your body if you don't need it. But if you need it, it's fine. It's completely fine. Like, I won't scowl at you because you have a tattoo. I'm usually just curious. That's kind of the thing about me. I'm curious. But I kind of feel like if you did it because you just kind of felt like doing it, then it's kind of weird. But it's fine, I guess. It's fine. It's freaking ink. It usually doesn't affect you long term, so it's fine. A scooch of sarcasm. Scooch. That's a weird way to put that. But yeah, it is cool to have a girlfriend who can be sarcastic and snarky. That's nice. Except when they, you know, when they do that, when they're actually pissed off with you, then it becomes kind of annoying. You know, it's always nice to be funny, like sarcastic funny. But, you know, sometimes being sarcastically funny can also be very, very annoying because it's like, okay, now I can't tell whether you're being honest or you're just saying stuff to piss me off. And yeah, that's a little bit of a thing. Number 15, making the first move. Now, this is finally something that I was going to actually talk about. Making the first move in any form of relationship or any form of, like, I don't know, friendship, men and women together, it's always nice because it shows, first of all, gravitas. It shows that you have the balls, you know, you have something to do. And this is for women specifically, because this is a list about sexy things about women. So it's nice when you, as a woman, are able to say, hey, screw societal norms. You shouldn't wait. I mean, to be fair, this is something that has existed for a long time and it's probably gone at this point. But like, doing that thing where you feel like he has to make the first move, he has to propose to me, he has to ask me out, like, come on, that's the least sexy thing you can do right now. And the weird thing, again, this is opinionated, because a lot of guys actually do prefer when they ask out first. A lot of guys think, you know, it makes them feel more manly, it makes them feel more capable. And that's, you know, that's to each his own, I guess. Number 16 is leading the hike up the trail. Okay, so this is another one of those sort of, I don't know, idiom kind of sounding things. I don't know why I said idiom, but like, it's not really exactly what it means. It doesn't literally mean you should lead a hike up a trail. You could, that's fine. But basically, they're kind of saying you should be more willing to be the leader a lot of the time. Don't always do that thing where you need your man to do everything, you know? Because this is a genuine thing. You notice anything, one specific good thing about any strong relationship is always when they both can do it together. You know, they both can raise the children together. They both can raise they both can do everything together. And that always helps because it's great. It's great when you both can just do things together instead of needing one person to do it first, you know? So yeah, that definitely does help. And this doesn't mean forcefully leading, especially when you know you don't have the capabilities. When one person asks, fine. But a lot of the time, you should be willing to say, yes, I will do it first. And yes, that sometimes a lot of the things that you have to lead in life usually require more strength or more something or something that a lot of women just don't have naturally. So like, a lot of the time it is like, it is based on the person, I guess, but a lot of time, yes, guys should do it first sometimes, but at the same time, it's fine if you take up the mantle and just lead, you know, it's nice. I don't know why I stretched that out so much, but like, that's pretty much what I'm trying to say. Social media restraints. Now, this is for, I feel like this is more tending towards the younger people. I don't know, I'm saying it like that, I'm freaking 22, but like this is a specific thing that I really genuinely don't like, where some people don't have any form of physical interaction capabilities, so much so, like so much so, to the point that they can't even talk to people physically, they can't even interact physically, they can't do anything. And good God, have I seen so many women like that. Like, good God. I had a friend, like, I have a friend who legitimately, like, had a date with a girl, and she told him, like, no, she didn't tell him anything. They were having a date, and he was, like, trying to, like, talk to her and stuff, and she just didn't respond. Like, she was just, every second, she would just check, look at her phone, scroll up and stuff. And it's not one of those things where you know she's busy, and it's also not one of those things where you know she doesn't want to be there, because sometimes some women genuinely like being there, but the way they show that they like it is by using, like, is by taking pictures. You know, when she was doing this a lot, it got him so pissed that he just stood up and walked away. Like, mid-date, he just stood up, walked away. Nothing else. Just stood up and walked away. That was it. Like, he didn't even talk to her, he didn't call her, he didn't do anything, he didn't follow her. He just stood up and walked away. And this goes to show that she clearly probably wasn't even too much into the relationship. She wasn't so, like, in, like, up there. Because trust me, if I was really into a girl and I was doing something that was pissing her off and she just got up, I would probably try to follow her along and be like, hey, I'm sorry for what I was doing. Like, if I could apologize, I guess. And if she could take the apology, then cool. If she couldn't, then, you know, we move our separate ways. But the fact that she didn't even follow along, like, that's clearly not meant to be, I guess. And he has a good girlfriend right now, so it's fine. The next thing, number 18, is not texting back right away. Which, first of all, it is sexy when a girl is just constantly active enough to text you. But also, it's, you need a little bit of boundary sometimes, because there is one specific thing I will say, which is like,
that's great. So yeah, that is one of those things I'll say. So not texting back right away sometimes, it's fine, as long as it's not like some important text. I feel like if it's an important conversation, you should always text back. Like, that's always, especially when you know that you can see the text and it doesn't take that much effort, okay? And a lot of people, a lot of freaking millennials will be like, yeah, but, like, you know, just the text, and it's not that much work, okay? And remember, this is about relationship stuff. This is not friendship stuff. If it's friendship, it's fine. Like, who cares? You can text back whenever you want. Like, I have a lot of friends like that. I don't freaking care. Like, whenever I feel like it, I will text back. Fine. But you should just be willing to respond on time, you know, to, like, give them your time. Because that's always nice. And it is a sexy thing. Number 19, second to last, is, because I'm going to do 20, because I feel like I'm already taking too much time, helping out the neighbor, even if it's inconvenient. Again, one of those things where, like, the looking at kids and stuff, picking up kids and being, I feel like if they don't need it, it's fine. You know, if they don't need that help and you just want to be helpful, it's fine. Except for the fact that, always remember one thing about humanity, is that if you do too much good stuff, people will expect you to keep doing good stuff. It's a really, really big, it's a really big thing. Do not in any way, under any circumstances, choose to do good things just because you feel like doing good things. Okay? Don't do that. Only do those things when you know it's necessary, when you know they need help. Because this is a real thing. No matter how nice it may look at the moment, it's a long-term commitment. Like, it's even more of a commitment than being in a relationship to me. Because, like, it's like, you're doing this thing for that person, and they will start expecting you to do that. Especially when they didn't need it the first time. So in their mind, it's like, oh, so he just likes doing this, or they just like doing this. So it's fine. But sometimes, yes, it is nice when you just help out and stuff. But remember, only when they ask, or only when they clearly need help, then it's fine. And last but not least is, on this list, is reading in bed. I'm going to skip this one because, again, 50-50, I don't really care. I feel like if you have a busy life, you wouldn't even have enough time to read in bed. Like, you know, this is just one of those, you know, they're assuming that these women are basically stay-at-home moms or something. I don't know, just, like, why would you read, what do you need to read in bed for? or something. Maybe you're just that successful that you're relaxed. I don't know. This is a bit of my Nigerian personality coming out, where I'm like a workaholic, and I'm like, if you're not working, then you're not really doing anything. You know, you're not really living, in my opinion, I guess. Whatever. Deep conversations. I think that's where I end up with. Deep conversations, that's definitely a big one. Like that's a good thing, and part of why I'm making a podcast. I love deep conversations. I love when a conversation can go way beyond what you guys expected at first. You know, I like when a conversation can just go beyond everything, can go beyond ethics, can go beyond just life, can go beyond standards. Like you can just talk about anything, and that's always great. That's always a nice thing. And the deeper the conversation, the better. I don't have a barrier when I have conversations. And this is part of the reason I said, I think in the last episode or something, that it's always necessary that at some points in everyone's life, you should reach a point where you just have mental isolation. Why? Because it does help to think. It helps to nurture your thinking. Because a lot of people don't do that. They just do whatever the heck they want. They just hang out. They just play around. They don't think long enough. They don't have that time to, like, they've not invested the time in just thinking, just conversing in their mind, trying to understand, okay, what's going on? What's this? What's that? Like, you need that time to think, because it really freaking helps to recollect, to reflect, to understand what's going on. And it's also nice when you and your partner do that together, which is why I said I'm a big fan of deep conversations, and I feel like that's definitely a good one to end on. And anyway, to not without further ado, let's end this episode very quickly, because yeah, it's already like 40 something minutes long, and I'm trying to like shorten these a little bit. At first I was gonna be like definitely over an hour at least, but then at the same time I'm like based on reviews from friends, I'm like, okay, I think I'll just reduce them to at least to like maximum 45 minutes. So yeah, that was fun. Maybe next time I might talk about sexy things about the universe, you know, more grand topic. Or maybe I might just go to something different. I have a lot of different ideas coming up, and I want to start making like regular, you know, I want to go back to my YouTube style as well as making the podcast. I'm always going to be releasing podcast. That's not a big deal. But I want to go back to also making like short videos where I really, really go ham in my editing. Because for those of you who don't realize, I don't think I've said this enough times, I'm a professional video editor. Okay, like I do that for a living. So I want to go back to really, really putting in the efforts and making videos and stuff, because it's really cool. I've just never really had the drive to do it for my channel so much, because I'm like, you know, it's not too big of a deal to me, but I want to go back into it. So I'll be making videos like that very soon, very shortly. You guys should be looking forward to those. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys will see me in the next video. Stay gorgeous, stay beautiful, and as always, get out of here.